thank you for coming. We are so excited to present to you today a play called The Unusual Suspect, about four students who tried to take revenge on a very bad principal. So we're about to get started, so please turn off our cell phones and remain quiet. Thank you.
Are you kidding me? People like me don't get sent to the principal's chambers unless it's like to be awarded a National Merit Scholarship or it's ours. What is this going on here? Here goes Yale. Am I to the Oval Office? Well, I guess there's still ITT Tech.
No pain, no gain. Agatha, Agatha Hart.
Good afternoon, sir.
I cannot express the grave disappointment I feel seeing you here in my office, Agatha.
I'm sorry, sir.
Quite honest, I expected more from you, Ms. Hawks.
I know, sir.
You have always been a model student.
Yes, sir.
A student who has in the past exhibited excellent leadership skills here at Golden Valley High.
Yes, sir.
Brought us numerous science fair awards.
Yes, sir.
Did our tutoring program, our food drives for the homeless. You read to the blind.
Yes, sir.
You were kind to the animals.
Yes, sir.
And a letter chapter of the Student Crime Watch.
Yes, sir.
Do you think I'm stupid, Ms. Hawks?
Yes, sir.
No, sir, I'm not.
I'm sorry.
I just hope this wasn't all a cover, Ms. Hawks.
I don't understand, sir.
Ms. Hawks, where were you on the evening of October 6th?
October 6th?
Yes.
Chess Club?
My records say no.
Math League?
Also no.
Band Camp?
Nope.
History B?
Mm-mm.
Brigadier Rehearsal?
Nope.
Fencing practice?
Yep.
Future Business Leaders of America?
Ms. Hobbs, though your long list of extracurricular activities is from the admirable, I'd appreciate a more
confident. Society!
No need to shout.
I'm sorry, sir. It's just.
I just remembered. I was in Film Society.
Film Society? I don't have any record of Film Society. Is this a new organization?
Yes, sir.
See, we just started this year.
Why not even be on the roster yet?
I see. So that's where you're. Are you sure?
Positive. We meet on the first Monday of every
month, and our last meeting was kind of boring. Constance?
Here.
Abigail?
Present.
Gertrude?
I was here at Ted Till.
Noted.
So, Adam, all of those are discussing between.
Why don't we focus on the classics?
Black and white or color?
I don't know, either or.
What if the films are color corrected? They count, right?
Of course not. It's an abomination, if you ask me.
I didn't ask you. I asked Agatha.
Well?
Sure.
What's wrong with the colorized film? Are you kidding me? It's so pretentious, and it totally detracts from the integrity of the film.
One, that's a matter of taste. And two, do you think if directors factored in what about opting for stale black and white? I don't think so.
Excuse me. That's not the point.
Then what is the point?
The point is that plenty of Academy Award-winning directors today choose to shoe in stale old black and white. Sorry.
Something in my throat. Has anyone seen a Publix Nova Redux?
Black and white is what makes them classic. They're at classics after they've been graffiti.
Oh, okay, is it getting hot here?
So you're telling me that watching Dorothy's ruby red slippers and glorious Technicolor ruined the whole film for you?
Yes, I did! I can't do my shoes were red. It's insulting.
Okay, perhaps that was a poor choice of topic. How about we focus on sci-fi?
Star Wars! Let's talk about Star Wars!
You sick traditionalist!
You heartless man!
Okay, that's not even a word.
And why my brother's a colorist!
Oh yeah? Your brother sucks!
And take it! Take that back!
No!
Please, stop it! We're similar people! Please stop!
My brother's color has a
color! No, but you fuck all yourself!
Friends!
I've seen enough. Thank you, ladies.
Thanks. You do not want to know what happened when Gone with the Wind was brought up.
Maybe when film society's over, they can try out for girls wrestling.
So that's it, sir. That's where I was.
And where did you go after film society?
I went home.
Straight home?
Yes, sir.
Is that your final answer?
Yes.
Can your parents corroborate the story?
I don't know. I guess so.
I hope they can. For your sake, I hope they can. Don't go in, Ragtha. I am not done with you. Well, if it isn't Golden Valley High's finest underachiever, Miss Hudson. Sorry, what'd you say, Hitler? It's Piddles. Yes,
it's Hudson.
To place some school properties?
No way, man. I made better. See?
Rock on.
You rock on too, brother.
That answer to your more research attention. Your guess.
Good, I'm looking forward to it.
And it's Hudson. I don't have time to play. We both know why we're here. I'm going to ask you one question and one question only. Where were you on the evening of October 6th, between the hours of 7 and 8?
October 6th. That was Wednesday, wasn't it?
Yes, last Wednesday. Now, where were you?
The Shady Palms retirement home.
I don't appreciate your posture.
Fine, I'll sit up straighter.
I need your attitude, young man.
Who's getting attitude? I volunteer them once a week.
You expect me to believe that you spend Wednesday evenings cavorting with the elderly at retirement homes?
I play Texas Hold'em with the old beavers, and plus Wednesday's meatloaf night. I don't miss meatloaf night.
Looky here! Led Zeppelin sure is in a hurry!
What?
I said, looky here! Led Zeppelin sure is in a hurry!
Hudson, our Joker is wow.
We've been over this, Sal. There aren't no Jokers in Texas Hold'em.
Hey, Hudson. Oh, these ain't good. I can't see so well with my glasses.
Sal, we've been through this. You can't show me the cards.
Do I have time to go to a cat? I really have to.
Can we play some cards? Just like, some.
My urologist says it's not good to hold your bladder.
Alright, it's not good for the pint.
Fine. But make it snappy.
What are you snappy on me for? I'm 83! Who do you think I am? That's Armstrong?
Check a bet, Sal. Sal? No surprises there. Sal folds. What about you, Irving?
What?
Never mind.
Did I ever tell you about my time in Korea?
Okay. To make a long story short, Moore went to the can 8 more times, Irving told some crazy war story, and Sal slept through the whole game.
Sounds like quite an eventful evening.
We call things the cast of conclusions eventful.
Alright, I think that's soon enough. Your poker buddies are free to go.
Alright, gentlemen,
bedtime!
Hey, Sal! You're Sal! Wake up! Game's over!
Who won?
A lucky guess.
Would you wake me up? I was having the best dream ever.
Oh yeah, what was so great about it?
I was 20.
What a handsome group of senior citizens. Do you win every time?
How do you think I got this iPod?
Well, we'll see soon enough what is still on your side.
Cool.
Parker behind that chair. You are not dismissed.
Mark my geek.
And await further instructions.
Whatever you say, P-Man. I got all day.
And here we are, our very own taste of royalty. How are you, Miss Davenport?
Hello? Faith's phone. Faith doesn't care. Faith thinks that's funny. Okay, Faith is a little busy right now, so Faith will have to call you back later. If Faith feels like it.
Do you always refer to yourself in the third person?
Of course not. Sometimes I call myself Princess.
That's not very surprising.
Okay, so can Princess go now?
Princess and I haven't even started.
Princess has a mani-pedi during her lunch break, and Maite hates it when Princess is late.
Well, I'm afraid your fingers and toes will have to wait.
Excuse me?
Say, where were you on the evening of October 6th?
God, I don't know.
Think.
Okay, let me check my sidekick.
Wait, you have a sidekick? Who are they? They should be found immediately. I need names!
This is my sidekick. Hello.
Yes, I need that.
Faith is shopping. Action now.
Do you keep a record of your shopping dates?
Faith sends an email to Tiffany on October 6th saying, Faith is shopping at Chanel. Nothing here is hot.
And who were you with?
I was alone.
Convenient.
Faith always shops alone. Last I checked, that wasn't a crime. Buffy, Muffy, Tuffy, get in here! Faith doesn't have all day!
After service, Miss Davenport.
Princess!
Sorry, I meant Princess!
Lindsay's colors are all wrong for Faith. Faith's a winter, Lindsay a summer.
Of course, these never work. What was I thinking? This will look absolutely divine on you, Miss Davenport.
Princess!
You must try these sunglasses, Princess. We just got them in.
Too tacky, oh.
This cardigan is 100% cashmere.
Two desperate housewives.
This is the worst clothes that Lindsay has heard.
Faith would never wear Jessica Sloppy Seconds. That would totally be like dating Nick.
Oh, Miss Davenport, I'm sure we'll find something hot.
Princess!
Princess, Tuffy, get
Hepburn. Princess, and hello, I'm like 17.
Of course you are, but you're worthless. I need to quit my day job.
Wow, now that's hot.
This? You want this? Oh, yes, so much better on the princess.
And that scarf is ultra hot.
This? Princess wants your scarf, Muffy.
But it was my mama.
Just give it to her.
How do I look?
It really brings out the colors of Princess's eyes.
Yes, yes. Faith, please.
Wonderful. Fantastic.
On second thought, Faith will take it off.
All of it? Then can I have my scarf back? Tuffy, get in here. Princess is taking everything. Taking everything?
Dude! two.
I promise when I'm greedy, I will not feel like laughing. The date is at the bottom. October 6th. You know what this is?
It's just a topless guy's head.
Take a closer look at the hair, Lucas.
It's got Jill in it?
The color. The person in the photo has dark hair.
And?
I can't help but notice your hair.
Thanks, I conditioned it regularly.
Your hair is dark, is it not?
Alas, it is.
Then it's fair to deduce you may be in this photograph.
Right, because, you know, people with black hair are extinct.
Is that all you got? Sadly, Lucas, whenever there is trouble, you aren't too far behind. Apparently, certain camera wires were slashed, cutting off live feed. The job was quick and precise. The perpetrator, using a small, sharp tool, probably one not unlike this. Recognize this, Lucas?
Yeah, it's my knife. I mean, I realize you were pretty jealous when you saw my masterpiece on the table, but you really gotta get your own knife there.
Listen here, young man, I do not know what you are up to, but I promise I will get to the bottom of it. Mark my words, you are going down!
Whatever. Does this mean I'm not getting my knife back?
What is that smell?
Nail polish? Faith must have many petty and my tea doesn't make house calls.
Why, besides myself with grief, however can I make it up to you?
You can step by letting
out. Faith needs to sit back down! I'm going to ask you one more time. Where were you on the evening of October 6th between the hours of 7 and 8?
Hello? Faith told you. Faith was shopping at Chanel.
Hello? Then why was Faith's credit card here that night?
What?
Civic Steve. Apparently Faith wanted something from vending machines and didn't realize that took only singles.
Faith doesn't know what you're talking about.
The vending machines were in fine working order when school went out Wednesday afternoon. And first thing Thursday morning, maintenance found this credit card jammed inside with your name on it.
Faith has tons of credit cards. Anyone could have stolen it.
Anyone would have had the sense to use change to buy bag chips rather than plastic. Alright then, now that I have Faith's undivided attention, would you care to change your story? Suit yourself. Looks like the reign of the princess may soon be over.
Alright, Mr. P. Back.
Good news, Chad. You are free to go.
It's great. Oh my god, it's great, dude. I mean, it's great. I mean, guy, man, sir. It's great. It's great. It's great. Yeah, it's gonna go on. Yeah, great.
Yeah. Well, an eyewitness saw you on campus on the night in question, but it is absolutely apparent to me now that the only crime you are intellectually capable of is battling someone.
Thanks, that's great, Mr. P. If I heard, I could still make highlights. Hey.
Well, you certainly give me the term eat and run. What is that?
Oh, this is a protein bar. You want one? It's chocolate.
Why, yes, of course, Chad. I've always had trouble resisting sweets.
Here. There's one at train, by the way, so, I mean, be careful with those. Because you can't get them here. You have to get them, like, they're international, except, like, or something. So just be careful.
Wait. Hold it! These bars are manufactured only in Europe, you say?
Yeah, in Brazil.
Brazil's in South America.
If you say so.
So then, regardless, it's safe to say that these bars are pretty rare.
I guess.
Then tell me this, Lucas. Wait, I'm not Lucas, are you? No, stupidity is contagious. So tell me this, Chad. How did one's wrapper find its way into my office trash can last Wednesday?
Now that I think about it, they're not really that rare. I think they're just, you know, they're just sold at Target.
Wow, I thought it was nothing. Just a piece of garbage left by the maintenance staff. the smallest, most inconsequential item. You'll be having going there for a while, Chad. Have a seat. We've been here for quite a while. So, let me ask you one more time. How did one wrapper find its way into my office trash can?
Can you repeat the question?
That is it! I have had enough of these games! Tell me, what is going on here? Who are you working with?
Please excuse the following announcement. If you own a white 82 Volvo with the license plate number P1DSUX, your car is being towed in the east parking lot.
Wait, what license number did she say?
I think she said it sucks.
I repeat, white 82 Volvo with the license plate P1DSUX is being towed in the east parking lot. The owner should report to the east parking lot immediately.
It's my car! My baby! Why would anyone want to tow my car? Oh, sweet innocent child. We've got to get down there. Save my car. You, stay here. I'm not done with you. I'm coming, bestie!
Anytime, princess. He's got my mirror.
I've been ID'd.
Girls intercepted my credit card.
What's the call?
We're running out of time.
Let's show you abort.
It could still backfire.
Right. Just stay calm and focused. We have him right where we want him. Take a deep breath and go back to that day. The day that brought us all here in the first place.
Flashback. Time. 1 month earlier. 0700. Location. Computer lab.
SAT score. Only student at Golden Valley ever to be voted
brainiest, and most likely to succeed in the same year.
Well, I mean,
I demanded a recount.
You're a model student, Agatha, the cream of the crop. They really don't get any better than you. It must have been quite a surprise when you didn't get into Harvard this year.
Maybe they're just better applicants
this year.
My sources retrieved a document that you may find to be of interest. Please read aloud.
To whom it may concern, it is with the deepest and utmost regret that I cannot recommend Agatha Hobbs for acceptance into Harvard University. What? Oh my god! Although highly intelligent, Ms. Hobbs exhibits a weak character and is generally referred to by all of her superiors as a crybaby?
Whoa, brutal.
That's so
weird. What? I'm not crybaby!
That letter is the only negative part of your admissions packet. Had it not been submitted, you would indeed be heading to Cambridge in the fall.
Bummer.
Now, whose signature is at the bottom?
Patrick Piddles. I asked him to recommendation, not a burn letter. I can't believe he could do this. Thank goodness I asked Kimlin to write my recommendation letter for Yale.
Now, Lucas Hudson, senior. A history of delinquent behavior in middle school. But once you hit high school, you decided to clean up your act.
I figured it was time to grow up.
You did. Excellent grades in accelerated classes, impressive test scores, community service.
Wow, Faith is so impressed.
But no matter
how hard, how many teachers you won over,
and how hard you tried, there seemed to always be someone who just wasn't buying it. And somehow, every week, you still managed to find yourself in detention.
No matter how hard I tried, Piddly always managed to get me into detention. I got a week's for having my shoelace untied, once for drinking Red Bull on campus. Man, he even had me once for having my flyer down.
It must be hard to always have someone on your back like that.
I mean, I figured if I was gonna get in trouble anyway, might as well have some fun, right?
Okay, so what does it say about Faith in your little file?
Ms. Faith, they voted most popular by teachers as well as students since kindergarten.
Preschool, actually.
Not a day goes by where Faith isn't stopped in the halls for an autograph or to pose for a photograph with her adoring public. I'm sure I wasn't the only student body member who was shocked when you were voted to this homecoming queen.
Yeah, what's up with that?
I mean, I voted for you.
Of course you did.
It seems you actually did win. But unfortunately, someone manipulated the final count.
I knew it. I knew it had to be fixed. Chastity Carmichael has a total horse face. Oh my god. How'd she do it?
Chastity had nothing to do with it. Note the initials on the bottom.
P.P.? Mr. Piddles? I knew it. I knew it. Oh my god, I knew he fixed it. Ever since Daddy refused to build a new Piddles wing for him, he has had it in for me. This is the only way he can get back at me.
Oh, wait, so what did he do to you?
Well, it's no secret I'm an athlete.
To say the least, you've won Golden Valley a dozen state championships since you were a freshman.
Correct. And for this reason, Piddles found me valuable. My victories always seem to procure press for Golden Valley. Press that always seem to focus on Mr. Piddles and his amazing achievements.
Piddles
predicts
and victory. Proud Piddles pronounces,
I shall not be beaten.
What?
You gotta be kidding me!
Is that him in that photo?
Why is he blocking two spaces?
Why is he hugging and kissing your trophy?
It took four coaches to pry him off of it. Apparently, he wanted to sleep with it that night.
Hello? Awkward.
Is it just me, or is our school run by complete idiots?
To him, I was just a dumb jock, a greyhound. He forced me to focus on sports rather than education, making me skip class to train. One day, I told him I didn't think I wanted to skip class or practice anymore.
He told me, don't think, it's not your strong suit.
Ever since then, I've played the dumb jock role to a T, but secretly, I've been on a mission. A mission to prove him wrong.
Good for you, man.
In one way or another, Patrick Piddles has wronged every person in this room, and not just the four of us. I'm sure every student at Golden Valley has been subjected to his gross abuse of power. Which brings me to why we're all here. You've all been selected for a special co-op team. Your mission, should you be willing to accept it, is simple. Operation Make Piddles Pay.
Okay, I am in. I don't care what you say, I'm in.
So, what's the plan?
Well, wait, but we already have all this incriminating evidence.
Bring it into the office and retrieve any incriminating we can find. Data we can use against them. Then the power will be in our hands. And yes, we have all this evidence, but it's just small stuff. No, the tip of the iceberg. If we want to bring Piddles down, we're going to need a lot more than just bad rep letters and homecoming miscounts.
What do we have to do?
Glad you asked. Agatha, Erwin, your role, intelligence. You will hack into Piddles' office computer, uncover all corresponding passwords, and decode any encrypted files.
Holy moly.
You won't be alone. Hudson, codename Slash.
Like a Guns N' Roses in this?
With your background in electronics, I'm hoping you can take every alarm and security camera on campus. Then you'll rendezvous with Merlin and search Piddles' office.
Please.
Faith, codename Nikita. Your femme fatale. You have traveled to South America on various holidays. Considering your impressive linguistic skills, you will act as a direct liaison to the custodial staff. Extract information they have on Piddle.
No problemo.
My codename will be Watcher. My role is surveillance. I'll keep an eye on Piddle once he's in school grounds and throughout the operation. Once he's at home fast asleep, I'll regroup with you all here back at school.
But why us?
I told you, you were all hand-selected based on your history of Piddles and your skills. I've been studying you all individually since last year, waiting for the perfect moment to recruit. This mission will fail without each and every one of you.
When is the operation going down?
3 weeks from tonight. This should give us enough time to train, gather our resources, and have the Now, I have to remind you all that this is a highly confidential operation. Included in your message is a list of approved contacts. Anyone not on that list is off limits, understood? Now, when we leave this room, we will carry on as if we were any other school day.
Then tomorrow,
700. We will reconvene to begin coverage. From this moment on, there's no turning back. Who's with you?
I'm with you.
Let's do this.
Agatha.
Come on, Brain. He's through the worst of all.
What do you say? They're Captain Four.
What if I got to lose? That is, the side by the entire
academic.